Hello YouTube, it's Tales Dog Goth, and I hate starting a video like this. I'm just really disappointed and other stuff. Remember when I uploaded that duck face test video? It was meant to be testing so I could use that new intro Beautilicious Gaming made for me on her video star on her phone. Well, guess what? It won't be coming because her phone is out of power and her charger is broken. Which means one thing. No, wait. One sentence, four words I have to say about this. I hate my Forgive me for being loud. Anyway, she's probably getting a new charger for Christmas. She started me again. Anyway, let's just get onto the main topic. I usually do top five videos based on Five Nights at Freddy's, but this time I'm doing Sonic the Hedgehog. I'm going to count down the top 10 moments from Sonic games which made me want to cry. Always forgot to tell you guys, is gameplay of Sonic.exe will not be on my playlist because I'm pretty sure that game would make anyone cry. Aw, poor thing. You know what he's like when he gets left out. Hold on, have I upset him? Just to warn you guys, this playlist is going to be a bit embarrassing in my opinion. Anyway, without further ado, let's kill the killer. This moment is from Sonic Unleashed. I'm adding this in fifth place because it didn't really make me cry much. It nearly made me cry, but I was a tough gal and I held the tears back. This is actually the first ever cutscene from Sonic Unleashed. And rather the longest ones, actually. As you can see, we start off with Eggman and his egg fleet until Sonic comes. And he crashes the party. And it's another reason why this is in fifth place. Because I think this cutscene is also very cool. Not only is it heartbreaking and disturbing. After Sonic has Eggman in his place, Eggman tricks Sonic into turning over a new leaf. he actually believes Eggman. Eggman actually tricked him. Do you know what the weirdest thing is? Sonic can fly. He could have flown out of that thing and he wouldn't have gotten caught. And this is the bit when the nightmare begins. Eggman takes the Chaos Emeralds away from Sonic. And it looks so painful. Because Sonic like screams at the top of his lungs. And I get the feeling he's using the Chaos Emerald to power up his laser cannon, which will create doomsday to the entire Earth. You know, I find this scene shocking because Eggman actually succeeds with destroying the world, and it's really shocking. Yeah, not only that, it also, the Earth crumbling and tearing apart releases Dark Gaia from its slumber. And yeah, that's really disturbing. It just makes me cringe. And, I'm not sure whether to add this bit in, but, I used to find in Sonic's werehog form really terrifying. That's for another video, obviously. I mean, just look at him. He's so terrifying. Yeah, but this is the reason why it makes me want to cry. It's the bit when, Eggman sent Sonic off to his death. It's, like, horrifying. And just look at him. He could combust down there. The weirdest thing is he doesn't even combust on his way down. and just the torment, and it felt like my mind was tormenting me, because at the end of the cutscene you'll see fully destroyed Earth. Even though it made me a little too overexcited the first time, well, that's only in my stomach, obviously, how it felt. I'm placing this in fifth place because if Eggman didn't destroy the Earth and turn Sonic into that giant werehog thing, then why else would we have this game? Sonic 2 for the Game Gear. I'm talking about the bit when you don't get all the Chaos Emeralds in Sonic 2 for the Game Gear. If you don't get all the Chaos Emeralds from Robotnik and fail to save Tails, after running for 3 minutes, Sonic will stop and look up at the sky to see the horrible loss of Dun Dun Dun! He failed to save Tails! Tails is dead! You know, that actually, he gave a game developer, Nova, an idea for an EXE game. Sonic2.exe. Story of what happened to Tails after Sonic failed to save him. Yeah, but like I said before, I'm going to try and leave the .exes out of the way. Poor Tails EXE. He looks so sad. Oh! I seem to have upset him even more. This moment has shocked me, and it made me feel really sad. Mind you, it is just a game, and I'm pretty sure you'll be able to get the Chaos Emeralds next time, right? Sonic Generations for, I don't know, probably PS or something. I love this game. It's rather a cool game. You get to play as classic Sonic and modern Sonic. However, there is one heartbreaking scene that I really wanted to disagree on. But it's just like Sonic Unleashed. This is the cutscene when Sonic arrives at a surprise birthday party his friends made for him. But after when Tails gave Sonic a chili dog, dun dun dun, something terrible happens. A dark void blows his chili dog out in the air, and that time eater. This giant time eater monster shows up, creates giant limo holes, which suck everyone in. You know what's weird? Knuckles held on longer than Amy. But the most awful moment was when Tails gets sucked in there. Just look. Sad, right? It's like Sonic is being separated from his body while Tails is like floating around in a giant limo without a body. But yeah, when I meant just like Sonic Unleashed, I mean if that time eater wasn't there and sucked all his friends in and destroyed time, we wouldn't have had this game. There's a reason why we have problems sometimes. Good luck, Sonic, getting your buddy back. But don't worry, Tails and all of his friends get back in the end. Thanks, Sonic the Hedgehog 2006. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you guys know this game for a long time, right? Let's focus on the final story for 1 second. Why did I say 1 second? Sonic doesn't see Mephiles behind him, perfect Mephiles, And then he shoots Sonic. Check it out. Sonic can step on his tiptoes. Either that or he's floating. You know what the shocking bit is? Sonic slowly falls to his death. Best Sonic game ever. Elise has this type of disease inside her body that if she cries, she will cause doomsday. Well, since she loved Sonic very much, who had to save her a few times, you'd probably know what happened.
No. No.
Yep. Poor Elise. Mephiles, what did you do to him? Mephiles! You monster! As we fast forward, we then see Elise stroking the dead Sonic. Yeah, it's pretty graphic. Poor Amy. I mean, we all see an almost dead hedgehog. Our hero. However, this is the bit that makes me want to cry. With the annoying Barbie girl. Before I reveal my eye weeping moment, here are a few weeping honorable mentions.
This is what you wanted, right? This is my promise I made to you.
Truly think is right.
This is awful. You're just some incomplete monster.
Okay, now that we've gone through all the sadness, well, not exactly all the sadness, I'm going to show you the moment which actually made me cry. It made me cry. Let's just get to it. Okay. I'm not sure if this contains spoilers or not, because even though I use the word spoilers in my Everything Wrong with Sonic EXE video, I still have no idea what spoilers are. Let me know what it means in the comments, and thank you so much. Anyway, why am I even talking like this? Let's just get on with it. Sonic Heroes. Sonic Heroes. I used to play that a lot on my PS2. But when me and the Lethal Sprout saw the last cutscenes, it was then time for something horrifying to begin. Metal Sonic was the one who held the key. After all. Oh, so is that what spoilers mean? Okay. He then lightnings the sky, and that breaks Eggman's base. And that is when the horror begins. Amy and I have the same reaction. In the 40s selection of this time, this horrifying monster takes to build. Metal Sonic becomes the ultimate and horrifying monster. It's just so horrifying with the music, and it makes my heart pound. I just couldn't take it. I actually ran out. When I saw that giant metal monster, I ran out of the room screaming my head off, and I just didn't want to stop. I kept that horrifying monster inside my head. I remember it very well, and I never wanted to play Sonic Heroes again after that. As I am now, shuddering now. The evil overlord from Sonic Heroes is in first place for making me cry. Okay guys, I'm gonna leave it there, finally. Yeah, go ahead and get some tissues, I feel a lot better now. See, look at my smile. Okay, before I go, I need to confess something. The creepypasta series of Sonic the Hedgehog doesn't make me cry. Unless it's round2.exe. I have no idea why. I'm not a fangirl, by the way. Anyway, I'm gonna cheer you all up. Hopefully, because I hope. I'm gonna cheer you up by saying my new outro. My new outro is still here, but my new intro is gonna have to wait. Well, hopefully this cheers you up, because I hope you're not afraid of the girl making a duck face. Quack, 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 girl!